gayness is gonna come out of this video. Like, doing a pride video, like, bitch, you know it's gonna be the campest thing you've seen all year. Like, I mean, me being Ariana Grande at the iHeart Awards, that's what it is. Ignore the stubble as well, I'm turning quite masculine. Can you tell? I also look like I've just been, I don't even know. Ignore the state, that's what I'm saying. What's up, buddy? Tom here, and welcome to something I've never done before, surprisingly. I've never done this. I didn't do this last year. I don't know what, ow. Bitch, you out of order. Sorry. Anyway, I didn't do this last year for Pride, and I don't know why I didn't. I just didn't. I didn't really think of the idea. But now I'm here and I'm doing it. So basically, today, this will be the first video that you see. Today, I consider Pride Day. It is the last day of Pride Month, the 30th of June. And I think it's cool to just upload quite a few videos on Pride Day and to essentially be gay as fuck. Literally do the campiest shit possible. However, today is more of a serious video.
So first off, I feel like I should start at the beginning of like when I discovered that I was different. For me personally, it was sort of like back in 2009, 2010. So I was about 7 or 8 when I sort of realised, oh, I like girls and boys. And then as I grew a bit older, it sort of started to change to, like, mainly guys. However, something that people don't know to this day is my sexuality is not technically gay. It is technically, I'm not pansexual. However, I'm quite, like, I like boys sexually. I'm attracted to boys, meaning that I would sleep with a boy and I'd have a relationship with a boy, which I am. However, I wouldn't have sex with a woman, but I'd be in a relationship with a woman. So my sexuality is confusing. I don't think there is a name for it. However, fuck it. You know, I am who I am. I'm a human being. I love whoever I want to love. That's it. The end of the story. Sorted. Doesn't need to be a label or a classification of who I am, okay? So, haters back on, okay? Thank you. Anyway, so yes, my coming out story. So, this all started back in 2019. Ugh. Actually, to be honest, 2019 was my favourite summer. It was. I loved summer 2019. Anyway, getting away from what? So, summer of 2019 was the first time I sort of ever talked to a boy. I'm not going to name the boy. They know who they are. But summer of 2019, I talked to this boy for about 2 months. And they were out to their parents, but I wasn't. And they didn't live here in Sheffield. So I sort of started to feel, okay, my life would be a lot better if my parents knew. Because then, you know, whether it's with this boy or another boy, if they live far away, I have more of a chance of being able to go and see them, or I have a chance of, you know, meeting with them. So I thought, okay, without, you know, pushing myself too far, let's not tell my parents yet. Let's tell my friends. So the first person I told was Ellie. I told my friend Ellie, and she was like, oh my god, we knew it. I was like, yeah, okay, whatever. And the thing about coming out that not a lot of you may know, because some of you may be straight or some of you are closeted. Ugh, hate that word. I'm going to try and find a different word for it. Not out yet. Yeah, so for people that don't know, when you tell someone your sexuality, you sort of get this sort of like adrenaline rush. Of like, I want to tell everybody. I really want to tell everybody. I want to see what everyone's reaction is. That was a good reaction. Maybe someone will give me a bad reaction. Maybe someone will give me a better reaction. It's this sort of like adrenaline rush of like, I want to tell everyone. But you're like, wait, I probably shouldn't tell everyone because then you know, things will go horrific. So I didn't. I just sort of told, I think I told about 10 people. Now that might seem like a lot, but that was sort of like my main clique at school. I told Ellie, Alanya, Georgia, Molly. I think we all had a group chat, so I told them. I told Declan, and a few other people as well. Who else did I tell? Emily, Frankie, who else did I tell? I can't remember who I told. It was such a long time ago now, I'm like, whoa. Yeah, I told all of them, and they were all so supportive and so lovely, and they're like, oh my god, we love you, and I'm like, thank you. And by this point, I was no longer talking to the lad, we were just friends, so that sort of threw things off. But, essentially, there was always the chance of that happening again. It never did, but there's always the chance of that happening again. And I decided to buy this. Now, in here, I'm going to show you them, but I'm not going to read you them. Basically, I decided to write letters to my mum, my dad, and my sister. So I'm going to quickly just show you. I did them in a golden ink. I'm not going to, like, allow you to read them. I'm not going to show you that them for a long time. But, like, you can see, I wrote letters to my parents. And essentially, they were just about me and about me being different and about me being gay. Well, in this, I put bisexual because at that time I was. I didn't really know. And I told them, and they were so, the thing is, the way that it happened is I wrote these letters and I was like, right, I'm going to give them to everyone on Christmas Day. They can't ruin Christmas. Like if it goes badly, they're not going to ruin Christmas. Like, okay. So I put this book high up away from everyone so that they wouldn't see it. And one day I got it out just to check that everything was all right, and I did a bit more writing and stuff. I accidentally left it out, and then I went to my nana's. And the next day, my nana was doing a roast dinner, and my mum, she sits next to me, she goes, "You all right?" I was like, "Yeah." "Fine. You okay?" "Yeah, I'm good." "Okay." And then I noticed that my mum went upstairs into this room with my sister, because my sister that was there. And I could hear them whispering that through the door, and I was like, "What's going on? Something's happened. Someone's dead. Something's happened." And then I got home, I put my bag down, sat in my bed, and just went, ah. And then I heard, I was like, "Yeah." And mum came in, she sat down on my bed, and she went, "Have you got something to tell me?" I was like, "No." So you know that feeling of like, oh shit, it's this, I've done this, do I admit to this? But then it's actually not that. Like, all those things of like, I've done all these bad shit, which is she on about? It was that feeling at that moment. And then, she just went and grabbed the book, this book, off the shelf. And at that point, I was like, however, my mum, she took it really well. My dad also took it really well, surprisingly. I was surprised that he took it well, to be honest. I didn't think. And then, obviously, my mum had told my sister and my nan, that's what they were talking about. However, I was really pissed off at that at first. I was really, really annoyed because my mum ended up ringing my auntie and telling her, asking for advice, like, what do we do? So she knew. And then all that side of the family ended up knowing within the space of like 2 days. And I started getting messages off them being like, "Oh, we love you. You're amazing. Na, 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 na." And then, yeah, it just went horrifically wrong. But yeah, my mum and dad came and talked to me. Everything was fine. And things were just all right at that point. They were fine. But then there was the greater task of fully coming out, which I still haven't. Some members of my family still don't know. However, I had to tell the rest of my friends. And now this is where the story gets weird, because I can't remember actually how I told everyone else. All I can really remember is the fact that I went to see Joker with Emily and Frankie. And before the film started, I went, "Do you know what? Shall I just tell everyone? Should I just come out to everyone?" So I posted it on my story. I was like, "You know what? If I can find it, I'll put it here. If I can't find it, then tough. But if I can find it, I'll whack it here. It's just basically like, this hoe is gay. You can't do anything about it. And then I turned my phone off, watched the film. And then after the film, I got floods of messages. Surprisingly, as well, from all the straight lads being like, ah, mate, well done. So proud of you. Da, da, da. And I was like, why didn't I do this sooner? It would have been so much easier. But, like, everyone has their time. Everyone knows when their time is right. And my time was quite clearly then in 2019. And now, I believe in July or August, I think it's July, with my 2 years of being out, which is, that's gone by fast. It's quite scary how fast that's gone and how much has happened within those 2 years. It's crazy. It really is crazy. But yeah, that's my coming out story. A lot of you had asked me to do this video, actually, surprisingly. I didn't think people would want to know, but a lot of you did. So thank you, I guess, for requesting this video. And here you go. You ask, you shall receive. That's my coming out story, guys. If you've got any questions or like anything you want to know, please feel free to comment down below and I'll be more than happy to answer any questions that anyone has. Like I said, this is Pride Day for me. No one else celebrates it as Pride Day. I do. But this is the day where I listen to the biggest gay icons there are. I jam out and just celebrate who I am and what people like me have fought for us, our rights and all that shebang. The next video I'm gonna do advice on how to come out. That's gonna be a really important video for anyone who's not out yet. Didn't say it. but for anyone who's not out yet, that is going to be an amazing video, hopefully, for you guys to watch and to listen and to hopefully take some form of advice from. So thank you all so much for watching this episode, guys. If you liked it, hit that like button. If you want to see more like this, then let me know. We don't just have to do this on Pride Day. I could do this whenever, but I thought Pride Day would be fitting. I did a Michael Jackson move then. thank you for watching, guys, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye, guys. Woo! Oh, no. I think I'm catching.